Alright, so at the beginning of the turn, this rebel army here has popped up, and it's of a sizable force, so I'm going to start bringing over remnants of my standing army this way, and it's going to take a few turns, so they are going to end up doing some damage against me, which sucks. But they'll be reinforced with the garrison of Asnan, and of course the garrison here at this fort here, and that should be enough to crush these rebels, hopefully. But, in the meantime, let's take... Nah, it looks like these Bactrians, it looks like they were eyeing it as well, so I get to take it before they do, though. So I'll see you on the battle map. So, here I am. This is going to be a pretty decent thing. I'm going to bash down the gates and then just charge through and take the town square. Very, very simple. Alright, so I've bashed down the gate, so I have two options. I could either send in my Takabara to take them out, or I can send in my cavalry. They're my general's bodyguard, this young fellow here, Vahaya, he's going to want to prove himself. He wants to actually take this town for himself. He wants to be the governor of it. So we're going to have him charge in. And then we're also going to have Kurus join in as well. So we'll just give you a few close-ups of this soon-to-be charge. Hopefully they'll only get one shot of their missiles before I'm able to charge through. And then go from there. Oh, luckily for me, they didn't even get the charge. So, now I just get to... Now I'm just going to tear apart these... This cavalry. And I'll actually send in Cyrus's fellows over to the side here to try to flank them a little bit. Now in the stand-up fight, I am going to take some casualties here because, of course, a Thon Rabata could get underneath these horses and stab upwards, that type of thing. But we're going to just have them stick in there for a moment or two. Now I'm going to just withdraw them, and now I'm going to charge in with Cyrus's group. There we are. Now I'll just charge here from behind one more time. Oh, there Cyrus is himself. Like I said, the man is no slouch. And there we are. Now they're surrounded, and the casualties on my side will be diminished. And they've routed, and that's the end of the battle. So, not very climactic, but it's one new territory for me, which is very nice. There we go, 32 losses. So, as always, we're going to emulate what the historical Persian Empire did. We're simply going to occupy this settlement. What I'm also going to do is I'm actually going to disband one of these fellows. So now, what I can do is I can focus on a town expansion. It's going to take 4 turns, but after those 4 turns are done, I should be able to build my own government-type building and make Ne a official province of my empire. So I believe what I said, the first place I wanted to build one was around here. So we'll do that. Let's see here. There we go. Fort right there. Now, does he... he's not able to get to there in time, but you know what he can do in the meantime is he can build a watchtower up here. There we are, so now we can have an eye on Fra here. Fira? Oh, no, it's just P-H-R-A. So, Fra! I'm assuming that's the enunciation of it. And let's see here. Yeah, these Takabara, very cheap garrison units, so we'll use them. And we'll eventually send this guy around to build another fort right about here, have it garrisoned. Oh, of course we don't want to forget about this fort here that we wanted to build. I guess right there will work. So we'll build that fort. Excellent. And then the final fort will be built right... What did I say? Around here-ish, right? Yeah. So, I can't build one there. How about here? No. Maybe in between these watchtowers? Yeah, there we go. That'll do. That'll do nicely. So, what was I going to use? Oh yeah, these Takabara here to do so. Now we'll bring Hatilda. He's gone far, far east. So now it's time for him to go back to govern Harmosia. Alright, so I'm going to just build a few more buildings here. In Teoke, we're going to build ourselves up a military garrison. And in Asnan, I think we're going to offer some regular taxes, cease the annual tribute of gifts, and now a calculated tax levy that officially brings the land under the direct rule of the king. So, I should actually build that while I say I'm going to build it. And finally, now that my spy here has done his job here, there's still a kind of a gray area here. I'm going to just kind of check out what's further east. Looks like another rebel territory tucked in the shadow of these mountains. So that might be the final rebel territory I might want to take. We'll see. I will see if the Bactrians or the Indians don't take it from me first. Alright, so at the beginning of the turn, it looks like my family members have been busy. I have 3 new family members, so let's just take a quick look at the family tree here. Oh yeah, so it looks like all of the sons, actually, with the exception of... Oh well, not all the sons, I suppose. Well, this guy's still only 19 years old. Plenty of time to start a family. But looks like it's 2 sons and 2 daughters, which is nice. So, now I'm going to build my final fort here to guard against the Bactrians in case they decide to turn violent. And we'll garrison that as well. Very nice. We'll send Hatilda closer back to Harmosia. Once again, very good. We'll bring this army closer to this rebel scum. Now, will I be able to get my guys here in time? No, I won't. So, I'm going to... Well, I'll be able to get the Hastapes there in time. But not the rest of these fellows. So what we're going to do is we're going to take out this garrison. We're going to move it towards this fort first. And that way ensures that I can attack them next turn. Alright, so I did a little bit of calculation of my financial screen. And considering how much income I'm making, I can now spend... I want to keep about 3,500 per turn to, you know, build in my settlements to help my infrastructure. And if I take this, what I already just spent this turn into account, I have about a little over 700 to spend on my standing army. So we're going to expand that quite a bit. I really like these Anusias and these Takabaras, so I'll build one of each. And then what I'm also going to build are 2 units of Thondrabata, so I'll do one here and one... Ooh, Strucatian archers. What are they like compared to my Thondrabata? Let's see here. Melee 8, missile 5, defense 10. Versus... Melee 8, defense 5. Oh, so they have a slightly better defense. Alright, you know what? Let's take some Strucatian archers too then. We'll take some Strucatian archers, and then one Sparabara, which we'll take from Asnan, I think. We'll recruit them from there. Remember, this is just a guaranteed standing army that I'll have all the time. When I shift to actual war, I will kind of forsake some of my construction, infrastructure construction, for the sake of a military. So, right now, looking pretty darn good. Oh yeah, sure enough, my spy has come across another settlement, Paktia. So, that is a possible expansion opportunity after I finish with Neh here. So, sure enough, I can build a Bel Ali, a city lord, here in Neh. So we're going to keep Vahaya Visdapaya of Patrigada here as the governor. He's a little young, but he was brave in that fight, so we'll reward him by giving him a bonus year here. And we're going to send our faction leader, Kairos, back to his capital eventually, which is the shortest route, I guess, the way he came, which is up here this way, which is nice. Now, unfortunately for Neh, they are not as happy. They are happier with the old guy. They didn't like the new guy, so we're going to lower the tax rate a little bit, make them happier. But once this large town is upgraded, we should be okay. What else do we have here? Oh, we'll send Hatilda back here in Harmosia. Now we can increase the tax rate, so that will cancel out the negative financial effects by lowering Nez tax rate. So far, the Indians are behaving themselves quite well. The Bactrians are, well, they're amassing a little something here, but I saw them fight, actually, they built a watchtower right there, it looks like, which is really interesting. Medians aren't giving me a hard time. I just have rebels, so there is a chance. I might go for Pactia, but we'll see. First, we're going to deal with these rebels. Alright, it's time to smash us some rebels. So we're going to combine all these forces here, and we'll have it led by Histapes the Horseman, who is now an occasional drinker. Of course, he hasn't had to fight very much, so I don't blame him for hitting the bottle just a little bit. Let's fight these rebels. So I do have, well, it looks like it's pretty even. The army strength ratio is 1-1. They have 2 units of Takabara, 2 units of Sparabara, 1 Thonribata, and the rebel general. But I personally think I have better quality than them. But we'll find out. I'll see you on the battle map. Oh, wait a second. Sorry, before I do that, look, there's this little attempt to knight attack thing, which actually gives me a bonus. And I remember there have been a few viewers who are like, I want to see this knight attack thing. So this will be the first of any of my Let's Plays where I do a knight attack. Let's see how well that works out.
Saddle the horses.
Ooh.
Drink the last of your wine. Fate awaits us, soldiers. Fate has decided our destinies.
Yay! All right, let's start the deployment. So here's my setup. It's kind of weird, but what can you do? I have 2 wings of my Asabari. I have my Thonribata here on loose formation in the front. Then behind them, I have these Sparabara on guard mode. And then finally, I have my Anusia. That is, they're also on loose formation, and I'm going to stick them on fire at will as well. Finally, I have my general and my Takabara here in the back to make a specific strike when I need to. So let's start this battle. Now, the bad news is that they have a hill advantage, which really, 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 really stinks because they have some decent missile units. So what I'm going to have to do is I am going to bring up my cavalry real quick. I'm actually going to stick them on loose formation as well right now because they might get the initial shots of this. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to actually just bring up my own Thonribata right there. And of course my spear's kind of behind. And then what I'll do, I think, is just kind of leave these guys back a little bit for right now.
March.
Just for right now, just to see what happens. And maybe do an attack that way. I'm going to have them all run. Like so. And now these guys are on loose formation, so we're going to actually have them charge up to the hill here as well. Oh, and I want to take them off of fire at will, because I want to save them for that general's bodyguard. So this is pretty neat. Wait till you start to see the arrows fly. In the dark, it looks really, really cool. Alright, so there's my loose formation. Anusia? No, Asabari. Oh, all these names that I can never remember. So there's the Thonribata. If I can make a strike against them, I will. You know what? Let's put these guys on tight formation real quick, and then I'm going to charge them there. Now it looks like these guys can fire, but these guys can't just yet. So we're going to bring them up, like so. There we go. Put in their little spear bodyguards right there. Now these guys here, now I want to see them make a move first. But I'm going to bring up these guys right there. But we're going to keep these guys kind of back here-ish. And my general around here.
Move out. Forward.
There we go. Ah, there we go. Check out those fire arrows. Looks really cool in the night effects. Alright, anyway. Where are these guys? Aha! Alright, so we're gonna make a strike against their Thunderbata. We're gonna put these guys in close formation. Oh, here comes the general's bodyguard. Oh, maybe not. There we go. Ooh, who's this? Oh, some of the enemy Takabar have come here to play. That's neat. Let me just quickly... No, these guys are still pretty good. Just, they're all kind of in a line here. That's kind of weird. Anyways, I should probably do something to deal with these fellows. Let's just have them attack there. Let's bring up my own Takabara a little bit. Then we should be okay. So they have a downhill advantage, which stinks. Whoa! Neat. Alright, so now I'm attacking there. We're gonna flank them right there. Alright, these guys aren't doing so hot anymore, so we're gonna take them out, but this is gonna give me a chance to attack. The enemy cavalry, the rebel general's coming this way, so we're gonna bring my spears out to meet him. And I think what I'm also going to do is bring this cavalry around to meet up with him as well. Eventually. Okay, so let's see how these guys are doing. Oh, they're broken already. Perfect. Perfect. So we're going to reform these guys over here. Have these guys stop. Keep them doing their firing at will thing. Okay. Okay, and we're going to bring over my general here just to give my Sparabar a little bit of moral support. Here come my Asabari. Take care of this rebel general. Boom. Alright. The enemy general is dead.
Was a fool. He sacrificed himself rather than leading his men to a dignified defeat.
Okay, so these Thunderbata were hunting after my Asabari, so we're going to just charge in against them there. Let's just reform my lines a little bit, shall we? Let's bring up my Sparabara more along these lines here. My Takabara right there. General's bodyguard is fine right there. And now I think these guys are okay. I'm going to put them on fire at will. And see, now I'm picking apart the enemy force here significantly. Alright, I'm taking care of these Thunderbata. They're routing, so that's good. So we're going to just give you a few close-ups here, as everyone always requests. Bring up these guys. Okay, let's see these guys get hit in the back with a bunch of... Oh, wrong one, guys. There we go. Look at that. Very pretty. Look, you can even see... What's really nice is this looks like it's dusk, or just before the dawn breaks. But even the sky looks really cool. So, excellent. Now I'm hitting them on their flanks. Now, I'm sure the fire arrows aren't as accurate, but it does look really pretty in a night attack, so we're going to just go with it. I'm going to stop chasing after... Oh, actually, never mind. These guys are chasing after my Asabari, so they can go ahead and do that. If they're out of the fight, that's even better. So we're going to bring up my Takabara here, because it looks like they're going to be coming after my Anusia once more. Yeah, it looks like they're lining up to do that, so... We're going to get ready to flank attack them. Go around here on their flank. And they're just reforming, so they're just standing and getting shot there. Alright, let's bring in my Takabara there. Let's bring up my general.
With all haste.
Alright, so those guys are broken now? And these guys are now in serious, serious trouble. I've picked them apart quite handedly, I might add. So we're gonna just reform my main battle line, stick them right around. Let's see here. Well, the problem is that I don't want them to get caught in the crossfire, so we're gonna start. This is what I'll do. I'll bring them here, and I'm gonna actually bring up my missile units, like so. There we go. And we're just going to run them. And that should deal with them. Ah, excellent. So these Asabari can clean up these rotors. Then target there. So this is just an absolute slaughter, is what it's turning out to be. Just an absolute bloodbath. A fiery bloodbath. Which is an interesting type of bloodbath. Alright, so looks like the last little bit of resistance here, these Takabara, have come to meet me, so we're going to give them a welcoming party of some Sparabara and Takabara right there. And we'll bring my general around as well. Target them with my missile units. Oh, what's going on over here? Oh, some Sparabara have caught my dudes. My Asabari. Well, let's give them... Actually, now they're broken. So that's even better. So we're gonna just deal with them. There we go. So they're shaken. And that's it. That's the battle. So I'm going to clean them up and I'll get back to you at the results screen. So that was a clear victory with 859 kills and 83 losses. So for every one man they killed, I killed 10, which is a very good ratio. Alright, so with that, we will bring my garrison units back to this city here. We'll start bringing Histapes there as well. We'll keep this now diminished 38, which is an even cheaper garrison, which is fine by me. And actually, all the units that I recruited last turn, I'm having them all converge in the center here. So I'm going to end this session, and I'm going to end it with a question. Some advice to you guys. Twofold, actually. So I have enough money to actually create a nice little standing army here. And I've had some suggestions on what the army makeup should be. So I'd actually like to kind of make it official, I guess you could say. So give me your army makeup ideas of about 20 units. What would you like to, what would an ideal Persian force look like? Also, my other question to you is, should I go for Paktia here and you know, gobble it up and have this nice big purple blob right in the center here? Or should I ignore it and start making war? This is another question. Should I be the aggressor? Normally the AI eventually attacks me, and I'm surprised they actually haven't done so yet. So my choices right now are going after the Indians, which is my preference, because if I can take them over and subjugate them, then I don't have to worry about one entire side. I could also go after the Bactrians, steal some land off of them, or I can go against the Medians, which was the historical first, you know, strike of the Persians. So let me know what you think, and I'll be looking forward to reading your comments.